Welcome to a lesson on solving one-step equations involving decimals. Since we've already covered how to solve one-step equations, for the most part, this will be a review of adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing decimals. So let's go ahead and take a look at our first example. We have x minus 2.17 equals 9.9. So to solve a linear equation, our goal is to isolate the variable on one side of the equal sign. So looking at this equation here, we want to manipulate this so that it's in the form of x equals some number. But right now we have x minus 2.17 on the left side of the equation. So we want to undo or perform the opposite operation of minus 2.17 in order to isolate the variable. Well, the opposite of minus 2.17 would be plus 2.17. And we could add this on the left side of the equation as long as we add the same number to the right side of the equation. So we'll have to put plus 2.17 on the right side as well. And notice when I wrote this, I knew I was going to have to add these decimals, and therefore I lined up the decimal point and the corresponding place values. So now on the left side of the equation, minus 2.17 plus 2.17, that would be 0. So notice how we're left with x on the left side. And then on the right side, we have to determine this sum. So if we wanted to, we could add a 0 in the hundredths place value here. So now we'll bring down the decimal point and add the corresponding place values. So we'll have 7, this would be 10, so we put a 0 here and carry a 1. 1 plus 9 plus 2 would be 12. So our solution is 12.07, or 12 and 7 hundredths. Which means if we substitute 12.07 for x, it should satisfy the original equation. So let's go ahead and check it. Well, 12.07 minus 2.17 is 9.9, which does verify our solution. Let's take a look at another example. Now, this example is almost exactly the same as the previous example, except now, in order to isolate the variable on the left side of the equation, we'll have to perform the opposite operation of adding 4.93 to both sides of the equation. Well, the opposite of plus 4.93 would be minus 4.93. And again, we'll be careful here to line up the place values. By doing this, we have plus 4.93 minus 4.93, that's 0. So we have x on the left side. We bring down the equal sign, and here we have to determine this difference. Now before we subtract, let's bring down the decimal point, and we'll also add a 0 here in the thousandths place value. And now we'll subtract as we normally would. 5 minus 0 would be 5, 7 minus 3 would be 4. Here we have to borrow, so we'll change the 10 to a 9, so this is now 14. 14 minus 9 would be 5. And 9 minus 4 would be 5. So our solution is x equals 5.545, or 5 and 545 thousandths. And again, what that means is if we replace x with 5.545, it must satisfy the equation. And I'll go ahead and let you check this, but it does check. Moving on to our next example, we have x divided by 1.2 equals 4.7. So again, our goal is the same. We want to isolate x on the left side of the equation. So we want the equation in the form of x equals some number. So we don't want divided by 1.2 on the left side with the variable. So we'll perform the opposite operation, or we'll undo the division by multiplying both sides of the equation by 1.2. So we'll multiply the left side by 1.2, and then we'll multiply the right side by 1.2. So here we'll have 1.2 divided by 1.2. This is going to simplify to 1, so we have x on the left side, which is what we wanted. And now the right side will have 1.2 times 4.7. Let's go ahead and perform that multiplication. Notice we have one decimal place here and one decimal place here, which means our product must contain two decimal places. So let's go ahead and multiply. 7 times 2 is 14, carry the 1. 7 times 1 plus 1, that's going to be 8. Now we're going to multiply by 4. 4 times 2 is 8. We'll put it in the second column. And then 4 times 1 would be 4. So now we'll add. We have 4, 16, carry the 1. So we have 564, but we have to have two decimal places, so it's going to be 5.64. So we have x equals 5.64, which means it must satisfy the original equation. So 5.64 divided by 1.2 must equal 4.7. And again, I've already verified this does check, but I would encourage you to verify it yourself. Our solution is x equals 5.64, or 5 64 hundredths. Let's take a look at one more example. Here we have 3.5x equals 6.475. We need to remember here that 3.5x means 3.5 times x. So again, to solve for x, we need to manipulate the equation so it's in the form of x equals some number. And since we have 3.5 times x, here we'll have to divide both sides by 3.5 in order to isolate x. So 3.5 divided by 3.5, this would be 1 times x, or just x. And now we have to perform this division. So 6.475 divided by 3.5. So the first thing we need to do is move the decimal point to the right so our divisor is a whole number. So I'll move this once to the right, and we'll do the same to the dividend. So move the decimal point here, and then straight up into our quotient. And now we'll divide as we normally would. So there's 135 and 64. We'll subtract, this would be 29. Bring down the next digit, which is 7. Now we need to figure out how many 35s are in 297. Let's try 8. 8 times 5 would be 40, carry a 4. 8 times 3 is 24, plus 4 is 28. This looks good because the difference is 17, which is less than 35. Bring down the next digit, which is 5. Now we need to figure out how many 35s are on 175. Well, that'll be 5. 5 times 5 is 25, carry a 2. 5 times 3 is 15, plus 2, that's 17. Remainder is 0. So this quotient is 1.85, or 1 85 hundredths, which would be the solution to our equation. Which again means that if x is equal to 1.85, it should satisfy the original equation. So 3.5 times 1.85 must be equal to 6.475. And again, I would encourage you to verify this, but it is true. I'm going to go ahead and stop here for this lesson. I hope for the most part you found this a good review of how to add, subtract, multiply, and divide decimals.